Hi guys, this is the first video in a series of tutorials that show you how to create a blog with the static generator Eleventy and the utility first Tailwind CSS framework. It shows you how I created the blog for stubborncode.com using Eleventy and Tailwind CSS and aims to help you create and style your own static sites. First, we talk a bit about Eleventy and Tailwind CSS, what they are, why you would want to use them, and how to install them. Eleventy is a simple static site generator. A static site generator reads our content, feeds it to templates, and outputs static HTML files that we can upload to our web hosting service. There are a lot of different static site generators out there. Stubborncode.com was initially built with Hugo, which uses the Go language that I'm not very familiar with. Eleventy is using JavaScript, which I know quite well. It's also quite simple, but powerful enough that I can add more features in the future. Tailwind CSS is a low-level utility class CSS framework. Most CSS frameworks do too much. Frameworks such as Bootstrap or Bulma give you full-fledged components that are easy and fast to work with. However, this also leads to sites that might look similar to each other and are difficult to customize. Tailwind's classes give you the ability to create true custom designs, but that comes with a cost. If you want a quick design, you might still want to use a component framework. Tailwind resets all styles by default, which practically means that you need to style everything yourself. In order to use Eleventy, you need to install Node.js. You can get its installer from here. I prefer to use a Node version manager that gives me the flexibility to install and use different Node versions if I ever need to. If you're on a Mac or Linux computer, you can use NVM. I'm on Windows, so I'm using Nodedist. After you install Node, you automatically get NPM, a Node package manager. To use that, you need a console emulator. If you're on a Unix-like system, you can use a native terminal app. If you're on Windows, you can use something like Commander. You will also need to use a code editor. I'm using Visual Studio Code. Unlike other static site generators, Eleventy does not scaffold your project, but only generates files in an existing project folder. So in a terminal, you can create a project folder. Let's cd into it. And now we can initialize a node project with npm init dash y. The y flag will accept everything and give us the default configuration. You can either install Eleventy globally with npm install dash g, which is the global flag, then add Eleventy and then the full Eleventy. I prefer to install it locally as a development dependency. To do that, we just need to change the G flag to --save --dev. Gonna skip this through. Eleventy compiles any files that have a valid template extension in the folder of our project into an output folder in the root of our project named underscore.site by default. We can also tell Eleventy to copy other file types that you might need, such as images or fonts, which we will do in a later post. We'll also install Tailwind CSS through npm. Note that Tailwind is a post CSS plugin. Post CSS is a tool that transforms CSS through JavaScript. In order to use it in our project, we need to install a few more dependencies as well. So we can do npm install tailwind CSS. It obviously installs Tailwind. Post CSS CLI, which we're going to use to process our CSS. An auto prefixer, which is another post CSS plugins that add vendor prefixes to our CSS. with Tailwind installed, we can run npx tailwind init to create a tailwind configuration file. That creates a file in our project folder named tailwind.config.js. We'll use that to customize Tailwind. We also need to create a post CSS config file. That's going to type code space dot, which will open Visual Code for me. Then I'm going to add a file named postcss.config.js in the root of our project folder. And here we can specify which post CSS plugins we want to use. Just want to export an object. The plugins we're going to use for now are Tailwind CSS and auto prefixer. I'm gonna save the file. We also need to create the CSS files for our plugins to process. So I'm gonna create a new folder named CSS, and inside that a file named tailwind.css. This file will contain the following. Just gonna copy paste. When post CSS compiles our CSS, the @tailwind directive is going to insert Tailwind's base components and utilities classes into our final CSS file. In order to compile our CSS, we're going to write a script in our package.json file that's located in the root of our project folder. By default, the file contains the following script. I'm going to change this script to build, and we want to run the post CSS CLI. We want to provide the input file, which is the file that we created before, and get the output file, which is denoted by the dash o flag. And since Eleventy is using underscore site as the default output folder, we want our output CSS file to be in underscore site slash CSS slash tailwind dot CSS. We need to save this file and run the script in our terminal. And we can see that we have a post CSS generated CSS file, which contains all Tailwind's classes. That's it for this video. I'll see you in the next video, where we will begin creating the layout of the site.